Start talking. It's your nickel. Hiya, baby. Listen, baby. I'm very busy right now. I have an office full of people. Of course, I could be persuaded to drag myself away from all the excitement for a minute or two. Yes, I'd like very much to sit with you in front of a warm fire. I'll bring the matches. See you later. What is it now, baby?
This is Arthur J. Canister speaking.
Sorry, Mr. Canister. I thought you were my Aunt Millie. What can I do for you?
I trust you've heard of the Dragon's Eye.
Isn't that the nag I lost a sawbuck on at Belmont last month?
The Dragon's Eye is the rarest,
most valuable model train in the world.
Trains?
I recently purchased the Dragon's Eye at auction for $1 million as a present for Mrs. Canister.
When I went to retrieve it from the safe this morning, it was gone.
There was no sign of a forcible entry. It could be an inside job. I don't want to attract any adverse publicity. Might you be willing to take the case, Mr. Spade?
Look, Mr. Canister, I'm very busy right now. I have an office full of people.
I can promise you that I will make it worth your while.
Can you give me an idea of how much my while will be worth this week?
How does $5,000 now and $5,000 once you've recovered the train sound to you?
Okay, Mr. Canister. I think I'll be able to make time.
Thank you for calling. However, we have all the vacuum cleaners, encyclopedias, magazines, soap polish, and saddle soap we require.
Wait.
Oh, if you're the Fuller brush man, we need a new brush to dust our cache. The old one lost its bristles.
I'm watering the lawn with my tears.
Thank you, sir. And now I must go along and shampoo the chinchilla.
Listen, Amon-Ra, I've been trying to tell you that I'm Jake Spade, Private Eye, see? I have an appointment with Mr. Canister.
My condolences, sir. I am Churchill, the butler. You, Please, come in. Please sit here. I will inform Mr. Canister that you are here. Not to speak above my station, but I take it you're here to recover the stolen train.
That's about the size of it. Tell me what you can about what goes on around here.
Oh, I would never speak about the affairs of this house.
But?
I have seen Mrs. Canister leaving the house at night and returning at dawn.
Perhaps she's taken up astronomy.
Very droll, sir. Yeah. May I offer you some light refreshment? We have a vintage Coca-Cola you might enjoy.
That sounds swell. You're right, Churchill. Loved you at Yalta.
Yeah.
Mr. Spade, I'm Arthur Canister. Thank you so much for coming on such short notice. You must pardon my infirmity, but I was injured years ago in a particularly intense croquet match. May I offer you something to drink? A grape knee-high, perhaps?
Sorry, but the Fountain of Youth took my order.
Well, he should be back in about 5 hours. Mr. Spade, allow me to show you the safe from where the dragon's eye was so rudely ripped. Well, that's funny.
What's that?
It appears that the thief made off with the safe as well.
Smart. Very smart.
Thank you.
Not you, the crook. Excuse me while I dust for fingerprints.
Well, Spade, what do you think? Thank you, Churchill. Very good. Excellent. Extraordinary, really. Top notch. Bon chance, vieux crouton. So hard to find live help these days.
Hello, boys. Darling, I hope I'm interrupting.
Lover, you haven't interrupted since I said I do. This is Jake Spade, the detective I've hired to locate the dragon's eye.
Nice to know you, Mr. Spade.
Nice to meet you, Mrs. Canister. Sorry, it helped me concentrate.
Oh, that's so cute. You're the most darling detective we've hired yet, So much nicer than that Philip Marlowe we brought in when Churchill lost the parrot. Frankly, I'm sorry we found him.
But lover, I thought you loved Churchill.
The parrot, you imbecile. The parrot.
But lover, I thought you loved it when I gave you the bird.
I'd like to give you the bird.
What's that, lover?
Oh, nothing. Mr. Spade, do you have any idea who stole that choo-choo? It was a present for me, you know.
I'm working on it. Don't worry, Mrs. Canister. I'll find it.
Well, you'd better. I'm counting.
Mr. Spade, don't you think my wife has a nice caboose?
Arthur, please. This is a family film.
Now, you discovered the train missing this morning at what time?
Well, I came in here about 8 a.m. to smoke a cigar and read the paper, and I noticed it was missing at about 11.
You mean it took you 3 hours before you noticed the safe was missing?
I'm a very slow reader.
Slow reader. Do you suspect anyone in particular?
Well, I do, but I don't want to accuse anyone until I'm sure.
Thank you, Spade.
Well, I'll leave you two to discuss this. See you soon, Mr. Spade.
Nice to meet you, Mrs. Canister.
Come with me, Spade. I want to show you something. As you can see, Spade, I have one of the most valuable train collections in the country. So naturally, I'm always a target. This is my latest layout, which, as you can see, is still a work in progress.
Everyone ought to have a hobby, Mr. Canister.
You know what you need to do, Spade.
Look, Mr. Canister, I don't know what you're implying, but I already played the tiger rag on the piano today.
Just find the dragon's eye, and do it fast.
Come in here.
Jake, I didn't hear any magic words in that last sentence.
Please.
That's better. You know, I didn't leave Nero Wolfe to work for you to be spoken to without the usual manners. That's what's lacking in a real gumshoe these days. Manners.
So I'll stay late after school and write I will be nice to Hildy Johnson 100 times.
Keep it up, smart guy, and I'll stop baking peanut butter cookies for you.
Please, no. Anything but that. How can I get through a day of sleuthing without cookies? It's cruel. It's inhuman. It's putrid.
Get up, Jake. You're smudging my pumps. What's the situation, anyway?
Stolen choo-choo. Valuable. Made of brass. We need to find it.
Runaway train, eh? Any clues?
Could be the butler, Churchill. He seems like a pretty fast character. Or it could be the trophy wife. She seems to have plenty to hide and lots of hiding places, too. Or it could be Canister himself to collect the insurance money.
The train was insured?
Didn't you see Double
Indemnity, the movie with Fred McMurray?
Yeah.
What are you going to do, Jake?
First thing I'm going to do is have a quick snort.
Oh, no! Jake, you know what that stuff does to you! You'll have Ovaltine and like it. Sure, it doesn't pack the wallop of the other stuff, but you're on a case now. Snap into it!
What would I do without you, Hildy?
Well, you wouldn't improve your manners, that's for sure. And you wouldn't get enough vitamins. You'd have halitosis, dandruff, body odor, nervous digestion.
Enough already. Now leave me to be brilliant. Time's a-wasting.
I'm going to the luncheonette. You want anything?
Yeah, I'll have a vanilla malted. And why don't you stop by Nat's bar on the way back? Nat's always got his ear to the ground. I don't know how he pours a gimlet that way.
Okay, I'll be back in 20 minutes. Try to stay out of trouble. Thank you.
I've been expecting you.
I think I was followed.
And this is unusual?
Oh, you're sweet. Listen, I have to talk to you. I think my husband suspects I stole the dragon's eye to pay off my gambling debts and might be, right now, as we speak, sending some gorilla after me.
Did you take it?
Of course not. I may be a compulsive gambler, but I'm no thief.
What about the caboose strapped around your left calf?
A Christmas present from Arthur. I wear it always to keep me warm.
Yeah, I get it. The pot-belly stove within.
Bade, you've got to help me.
Cut it out, will you? The cleaning lady doesn't come in until Thursday.
Is there nothing I can do to persuade you?
Well...
Yes, Jake?
I'm dying for a yoo-hoo.
I was thinking about something more substantial.
An egg cream?
Oh, you shame us. I must say, you're pretty hard-boiled, Spade.
Doublemint?
Thanks, Spade, but I gave it up for Lent.
Well, no wonder you're so nervous. All right, I'll see what I can do to make sure you don't get mauled.
Oh, thank you, Jake. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hello?
Spade. Phil Dundee from Homicide.
Spill it, Phil.
You better get over to the canister place pronto.
What's all the panic?
Canister's dead. Not pretty. Looks like he was run over by a train.
Be there in 10. All aboard.
I am Matilda Phipps Mortimer Canister, and I'm very rich. I'm comfortably well off. In fact, I'm socially secure. Churchill? I'm chilly. Put some more Franklins on the fire. Thank you, Churchill. You're such a treasure. It's about time someone buried you. Mr. Spade, I want you to find the killer of my train-loving son, Arthur, and recover the stolen dragon's eye. If you cannot find the killer but recover the dragon's eye, then it won't have been so bad. If you cannot find the dragon's eye, I lost a pearl earring about 8 years ago, and perhaps you can find that. If you can't find the earring, I'm working on a crossword puzzle, and perhaps you can solve that for me.
Can you tell me anything else, Spade? We found this record on the Victrola.
Is that the Chattanooga choo-choo?
Yes, yes. Track 29.
Left front's low.
Looks like he was run over by the New York Central Hudson or the Pennsylvania Railroad.
Like shooting a Gandhi dancer with an elephant gun.
So, Spade, looks like you're trying to catch a train.
Don't crowd me, Phil. This is a very short film.
Name's Ditto. I'm interested in the dragon's eye.
Take a number. What station do you get off at?
Never mind the clackety-clack down the track.
Go take the 515. I'm busy.
Sorry, Spade. I'm going to search your office in case you have it stashed here. You may have already found it. Who knows? Maybe you're planning to hop the freight yourself.
Us gumshoes aren't as crooked as we're put out to be, Sonny.
If I come up short, it may be the end of the line for you, Spade.
Take it easy. I didn't do nothing.
Tell it to Jimmy Cagney.
Churchill, get us some drinks, will you?
Very good, madam. What would you like?
I'd like a night out with Casey Jones, drinking some night train to wet my whistle, but I'll settle for a boxcar.
Anyone else? Very adequate.
Now, I've brought you all together here to show you how I solved this mystery. It wasn't easy, but it was a lot of fun. And the good news is that most of you are innocent. First was the mystery of the stolen choo-choo. I would have heard through Eddie Harwood at the Blue Dahlia if anyone was trying to fence the train. He hadn't heard anything, so I knew it was still in possession of the thief. I knew this person was smart and left some kind of clever clue. I even missed my piano lesson. Skip listening to Inner Sanctum to work on it. Then I thought Chattanooga Choo Choo. It was full of innuendo. In fact, it was downright incognito. So, I went through the lyrics very carefully. Boy, you can give me a shine. I searched every shoe in the house, even those that weren't shined. Nothing. I called my friends in Baltimore. Nothing. Then it hit me. You can have your ham and eggs in Carolina. I searched the Frigidaire and came up with this. Considering the shade of lipstick, it could have been none other than Margot Cannister!
Yes, it was me. And I would do it again, if for no other reason than the many close-ups that have been given me in this film.
Then came the murder. Murder by falling under the wheels of a train. It was highly probable that the body had been moved from the train tracks and brought here later.
Brilliant!
I thought so too, but who could have done it without being seen and mustered up enough strength to drag the body into the house?
Please get on with it, Mr. Spade, as I have an appointment for a full body massage. After which, I am meeting with a band leader about my niece Minnie's wedding, whom I have no intention of paying.
Sorry, but based on the clues that have not been introduced to this plot, because we do not want to go overtime and some of us have to get up early, the murderer is... And the murderer is... Mrs. Matilda Phipps Mortimer Cannister, who is not the real Mrs. Cannister, but Arthur Cannister's brother, Sam Cannister, in disguise!
And I would have gotten away with it, too. One move from any of you and the glamour puss gets it. I see you getting that hand, Dundee. You'll be trading it for a harp.
Nice work, Churchill. This is your finest hour.
Thank you, sir.
All right, I'll take it from here. Come on, Lady Astor.
Hey, Jake, are you busy right now?
No, criminals on the fast track to Sing Sing.
Well, I have a big test tomorrow, and I wanted to know if you had time to help me with some math problems.
You bet. Speaking of you bet, do you think you can whip up an egg cream for my services?
Sure. I think Mom has some cookies in the jar, too.
Cool.
Oh, hello there. My name is Sidney Orchard Street. Perhaps you remember me for such classic detective films as The Thin Man Gets Fat, where I played the love interest. Or maybe you remember me for my role as the bank teller in The Maltese Whippoorwill, where I tallied up the bank interest. But I just want to say to all you young people, what do you want to be a detective for? You eat Chinese food out of a box, and you don't clean up nice. I know, the shigas that goes on with the fighting with the women, and you wear a suit that's not dry cleaning. Listen to me. Stay in school, and you'll eat Chinese food off plates like a regular person. My mother, God bless her, always said, Ehrlich ist schwerlich. My mother was Jewish. It's hard to be honest, she used to say. Crime does not pay, neither does being a detective. But she was right. Laughter is healthy for you. Lachen, gesund, health. So when you do the both, you feel better already. As a matter of fact, I'm feeling better thinking about it. I feel like, look at me, I'm starting to laugh already. I'm beginning to feel better too. Where's my coffee?